What's going on, hockey fans? Well, we have a packed 14-game slate to recap on this Saturday edition of On the Fly, including a marquee matchup on the Strip. Is Connor McDavid trying to stay red hot with a huge 2 points on the line against Jack Eichel and the Golden Knights? Oh, yeah, speaking of hot, Saturday started with the Flames torching the Stars for 6 goals. But was it enough for a dub in the Big D? Plus, the hottest team in hockey was looking to set a franchise record in Chicago as Seattle put their 7-game win streak on the line against the Blackhawks. Yes, somebody turn up the AC, because I'm LG Red and On the Fly starts right now. Original six matchup that we all love to watch, with bad blood for the 2019 postseason and, of course, star power. And the Stars entered this game shining bright as Brad Marchand and David Pastrnak have been rolling, entering the matchup with a combined 14 points in their last 4 contests. And, of course, Mitch Marner, whose career numbers against the Bees, yeah, they make Boston fans a little nervous anytime he takes the ice against their club. And enter Austin Matthews, who returned from missing 2 games with a nagging injury, with goals in 4 straight games against the Bruins. So get your popcorn ready, because this was a good one.
Stumbled there on a check from Tavares. Put into the slot.
Scores off with Wayne Simmonds, and Foligno takes his spot. Square off in the center circle, and they're going rock'em sock'em robots.
Simmonds finishes his hit. Good solid body contact. Carlo came over to answer for his teammate, but Foligno said, "I'll take it from here."
Man, he couldn't ask for a better start in this building. As you said, rarely have they had anything to be sad about here. And it looked to me like Eric Furlatt called for a trip, and Matthews back in the lineup, and you now see the 5-forward power play.
Marner works his way in, slick move, Tavares in deep, center, scores!
You deal with Matthews, you leave the secondary threat there in Bunting, and he's all alone, and Ullmark never even saw that one.
Ullmark still without his stick. Marchand winds around, Timmons finds Bergeron! The game is tied!
Go to the front of the net with your stick on the ice. Marchand will find you.
It's really remarkable the kind of start that they've had.
Here's Engvall. Scores! What a shot by Pierre Engvall! 87.8 miles an hour, and he fires the Leafs into the lead.
Shielding the puck, one hands it to Timmons. He telegraphs the pass. Pastrnak with Marchand middle. He scores! Marchand was a threat, and Pastrnak looked up and found the short side. It's 2-2.
Pops up the boards. Cross ice pass, Giordano. Oh, what a recovery by Omar. The save of the game.
Nosek evades Simmonds. Foligno to Greer. A.J. Greer scores. The Bruins lead for the first time tonight. How's your entertainment factor?
A good hand-eye, and it might create something. Here's Bunting. Matthews to the backhand forehand. What a beauty! Game time!
Well, Big Pappy did it in Boston.
It has been physical
and two elite teams. Carlo to Hall, tries it. Grizzlick scores! 1:16 to go! Matt Grizzlick, puck to the net, and it deflected in. The Bruins open up an 11-point lead over Toronto in the Atlantic Division.
The goalie never gets old, my friends, as the Bruins look to start a new streak at home as they beat their rivals for the first time since November of 2019. Now, Austin Matthews makes his return to the lineup in style with his 21st of the season. And Matt Grizzlick scores with less than a minute and a half to go for his sixth career game-winning goal. Here's the hero after the game.
Immense. That's something that we, you know, it's the first thing we talk about the next day in video, and obviously there's things we can go over, but it's more so just kind of having the dog mentality, and you know, something that we don't lack is resilience. So great leadership in the locker room, and Monty and the rest of the coaching staff get us you know, prepared and on the right track. We never lose two in a row. You know, we didn't like how we played in their building last time, and obviously we know the rivalry, so you know, we want to make a statement to the rest of the league tonight, and I thought we played, you know, really well. It was probably one of the best 60 minutes we played in a long time, so that's good to see for us going forward.
After the dub, the Bruins signed Pavel Zacha to a four-year contract extension through the 2026-27 season with an annual cap hit of $4.75 million. Now the 25-year-old has appeared in 42 games this season, tallying 5 goals and 20 assists with a plus-10 rating. Now this is Zacha's longest and largest contract in his NHL career. Now out to Chicago, where the Kraken look to win their 8th in a row.
Brandon Tanev, nice pass from Morgan Geeky, who springs Sprong. He's in, he scores! Daniel Sprong does it again.
It's Taylor Radish blocked by Ryan Donato. Jonathan Taves in front, Seth Jones scores!
Kind of went off the stick of the big defenseman, Alexiak, and into the net.
It's done to the point. Veneers covering, shot taken. They score! Matty Veneers from downtown. Isaac Phillips, 2-on-1. McCann with a shot and a dart. Jared McCann with a bullet. He stings Mrazek on the stick side. 3-1 Seattle. Hurried up by Burakovsky, Eberle. Now Beniers. Burakovsky scores! That's hockey, baby! Makes it 4-1. Eberle to Beniers to Burakovsky. Gord for the front. Tolvanen right there. They score! Ellie Tolvanen keeps the ball rolling. It's an onslaught in the Windy City, and the Kraken pour it on. Kraken have won or tied the last 17 periods, and they get another goal here. McCann, his second goal tonight. 6-1 Seattle.
Well, if you like the over, you're a winner.
Frees the puck for Isaac Phillips, who turns and heads up ice. Jason Dickinson reels it in. Dickinson for Phillips. Backhand shot, score! Gorgeous goal for Isaac Phillips. The first of his NHL career.
You gotta love this one. Look at him wheel through the middle of the ice. Takes it on the backhand, takes it on the forehand, switches to the backhand, and boy, he just fires this one right up into the top corner. Dickinson grabs the puck.
Back to Jones, 15 seconds on the power play. Domi wrists one and scores! And it's a 3-goal game.
Hey, you know, now they're right back into this. They've got some momentum.
Drops it off for McCann with 2. Make it 3! Hat trick! 7-3 Seattle.
Well, after huge outbursts of goals in Chicago, the Kraken win their 8th consecutive win, setting a new franchise record. Now, Matty Beniers continues to shine as he scored a goal and added a helper as well. Now, he leads all rookies in goals and points. Now, how about this? Jared McCann records his first career hat trick. Now the Kraken make it 7 of 7 on their road trip, with 3 of those wins coming against current playoff teams. They become the first team in NHL history to sweep a road trip of at least 7 games. Now the last team to sweep a road trip of 6 games or more and win the Stanley Cup that season was Boston in 2011. Now let's head down to Raleigh, where the first place Canes hosted the slumping Pens.
Puck lands in the corner, shuffled forward. Nice block by Malkin. Zucker's got a chance. Fires off the post.
Quick puck movement. Anderson looks behind him, and the referee waves no goal. And there you see Zucker's reaction. He thought it was in.
Carolina's power play.
And this has been a weak spot for the Canes. Not a very good power play this season. They're fighting a shuttle in the team's direction.
It was deflected on its way in. And the skate blade right there. What a save by Casey DeSmith just to get a piece of that.
And we are scoreless. Fetch the top. Lacrosse move. Attempt. Almost did it again.
He almost did it. He picked it up. Michigan move.
Worked across for Shea. Shea. Hey, and the score! Brady Shea. Patience. And fires a bullet that beats DeSmith. Canes grab the 1-0 lead. El Malkin. Going wide on Chatfield. Challenging. And his shot. And Anderson gets a glove to it. Knocked in the air. And then knocked down by Burns. Jarvis with 7 goals and 15 assists. Zaho
gets one to Chatfield, he scores! Jalen Chatfield, well, you know where he's going. His 4th of the season puts Carolina up 2-0.
He got to the top of the circles, and then he went to Kathmandu.
And Pittsburgh working the puck out the front. Anderson gets across, and he'll shut down Jason Zucker.
And Freddie Anderson made one big save at the end of the second period. One on Malkin here to commence the third. A really good attacking save on Zucker.
And the Penguins are back on the power play.
Sailed into the glove. Anderson, what is he doing?
Put it in his own net.
It's in.
Give it to Raquel.
Oh, my goodness. The Penguins are on the board. It's a power play goal, and it's 2-1. I don't believe it.
How about Raquel getting a stick?
He got a stick on that.
He did.
That was miraculous.
First I thought it was his body. It was off the stick.
He actually played it with his stick.
Into the corner it goes. Rust tying up Stasny and Burns. Puck will come free. It'll be deflected out in front. Backhand chance. Anderson with a save. Crosby whacks at it. Still loose at the top of the paint. And then you'll get a whistle.
They eventually call the cross check to Burns. Huge save from Frederick Anderson.
Puck in the corner. It comes out to the captain. Bounce in the corner. 1 second left. And it's over. The Hurricanes hang on for a hard-fought 2-win over the Penguins.
Hard-fought dub there for the Canes, who win their second straight, topping the Pens 2-1. Now, Brady Shea's goal gives him points in 4 of his last 5 contests, while Sebastian Aho extends his point streak to 4 in a row. Next up, we're headed to St. Louis, where the Lightning begin a 5-game road trip against the Blues.
What a class. The inaugural class of the St. Louis Blues Hall of Fame. And the legendary coach Scotty Bowman dropping the ceremonial puck. It's a special weekend here in St. Louis. Near the line, the veteran Corey Perry lost it. Now the Blues to center. Pitlick, he's got a breakaway. Shoots. He scores! Pitlick, and the Blues lead 1-0.
This line has been humming. This pass right through the guts of the ice. It beats a best goalie in the National Hockey League.
There's a chance for Point. He scores! And this guy is not missing at all for the last month. Braden Point ties the game. Here's Kucherov. Kucherov gets it to Stamkos. Stamkos in front. They score! Great pass from Stamkos right onto the tape for Braden Point. Another power play goal. 2-1 Tampa Bay. Shot by Perfect. With a shot that gets up and over Binnington, and it is 3-1 Tampa Bay.
And Kyrou back for the Blues, now for Thomas. Return feed for Kyrou. Buchnevich in the slot, gets it, shoots, he scores! Buchnevich, and it's 3-2.
Volk back in the corner. Hagel centers it across, Carr scores! What a play by Brandon Hagel. Just put it on a tee for Cologne, and it is 4-2. Blues work the puck down the ice. Binnington goes to the bench. So the extra attacker is on. It's an empty net. Here's Points. Kucherov. He's got Stamkos, and he fans on it with an empty net. Hold on. Here it is. Stamkos. No! Off a stick and out of play.
The hockey gods are not ready, folks. I mean, it's just not the time yet.
The Tampa Bay Lightning are going to start this long road trip with a 4-2 win.
And with that, the Lightning topped the Blues 4-2 to earn their third consecutive win. Now, Braden Point nets 2 goals and a helper for his second 3-point game of the season, both against the Blues. Now let's head down to the nation's capital, where Alex Ovechkin tried to slow down the red-hot Flyers.
Win that draw and go right to work. D'Angelo, little wrist and deflection, score! Scott Watton, another power play goal on the redirect, and the Flyers take a 1-0 lead.
The shot by D'Angelo is going to be tipped by Scott Watton. A little fly-by deflection right there. Great hand-eye coordination. And the Flyers with the power play goal and a 1-0 lead.
Van Riemsdyk fired, deflected away. Follow-up chance stop. Rebound, score! Alex Ovechkin hits 30.
Ovi on the backhand rips it up and over Carter Hart.
Alex Ovechkin, most 30-goal seasons in NHL history.
Ovi's tied the Hall of Famer, Mike Gartner. He was always a 30-goal scorer. A nice strike by the Capitals captain.
He turned it over to Frost. Back to Tippett. Stepping in front. The pass across. And they score! James Van Riemsdyk with a yawning cage buries it. And the Flyers are back on top. 2-1.
JVR slaps it into a wide-open net after that beautiful pass from Tippett. And the Flyers regain the lead.
Flyers win this draw. Hayes gets behind the net. The goalie out of it. He got it in front. The shot by Allison. He scores! Wade Allison with chaos in and around the Washington net. Able to get it through traffic. And a couple of quick goals by the Flyers have them up 3-1 here in the second.
Kemper goes to the Washington bench.
Poked that by Watton. Centered in front off the stick of Ovechkin and wide. Now Oshie in front. Ovechkin shot. Hart the save. D'Angelo plays it off of Watton. And it's Johansson. Cross-ice pass intercepted by Konechny, who fires for the empty net and missed it wide. And that'll be icing more for Konechny. It might have been the last chance he had to continue his point streak. And now it bounces to Kuznetsov for another shot that goes wide. 3 seconds, two. That's rolling all the way down the ice. And that is it for the Philadelphia Flyers. It's a sweep of the home-and-home series with the Capitals. It's 5 straight wins on the road. And overall, the Flyers have now won 7 of their last 8 games.
Well, another day, another record for Ovi. With his first period goal, he tied Hall of Famer Mike Gartner for the most 30-goal seasons in NHL history with 17. And on the winning side, the Flyers have now won 7 of their last 8. Hey, Torts, how clutch was Carter Hart in this one?
On our heels in the third period, I think that's when Carter just steps up big time. But it's a good team win for us. We did some really good things in the first two periods. The penalty kills were really important for us. They came at key times. And then Carter took over the game in the third. We're just cohesive right now. And I worry about saying that because I'm afraid I'm going to jinx it, because it can go away pretty quickly, too. I think Carter really finishes the game for us in the third period. I thought he made some great saves in the third.
When we come back, Connor McDavid celebrated his 26th birthday on Friday by scoring 2 in San Jose and then hopping on a flight to Vegas to face off against Jack Eichel. Oilers Knights highlights next. Sin City showdown that should rival even the best act on the strip, as the Knights and Oilers were set to go head-to-head in a Pacific Division matchup between the first-place team in the Pacific and a club that's been rolling on this West Coast roadie, outscoring their last two opponents by a combined 13-3 margin, with their golden boy Connor McDavid turning it up to 11 with 5 points over those two dubs. Now let's get you out to Las Vegas.
Here's the chance for Janmark, splitting through, he shoots, and he scores! What a start from the Oilers, picking up right where they left off from. It's 1-0 for Edmonton.
And then right after the next shift, it's a laser up the middle, and Janmark splits the defense.
Jay Woodcroft electing to send his superstars out, the dynamic duo. Here's McDavid, the shot, Thompson, and the rebound is in the net! Off the stick of Leon Draisaitl.
McDavid gets wide, gets it to the net, it's in the air, and again, Draisaitl just no problem both times.
Stevenson had a poke check away, Draisaitl overskates it, and then picked the pocket of Marchessault, trying to spin McDavid to the clear, to the net, Jack Thompson!
It's a
a big save right there off another turnover by the Golden Knights as he bats the rebound away out of the air.
Puck loose at the top of the crease. And no whistle yet. Squirts loose to McNabb with a wrist shot. They got blocked in front. Look at that, caught Bouchard. That high score!
For the Golden Knights. He dishes. Puck taken away. Dreisaitl with Nurse. 2-on-1. Dreisaitl keeps, shoots, scores!
And for Leon Dreisaitl, left-handed shot down the right side. Opens up, and he just decides to bury this one. Never really looks sick.
Now Frey's in front. Off the pass!
A little open space with a backhand.
27 points in 36 games with the Henderson Silver Knights. Here comes Queen Costin, shoots, and he scores! That's 6 goals in 8 games now for Queen Costin, who is just red hot.
Boy, is he ever.
Martinez, a good pitch. Marchessault protects it against Barry. Carlson scores!
Set up for a good final 20 minutes of play.
Stevenson down low, center up, right for the crease. Eichel couldn't get a tip on it.
Playoff started today. This would be a first round matchup. Campbell careful enough to stop that puck as it bounced towards him. And here comes Connor McDavid driving to the net. Stopped by Thompson.
Doesn't go right at him because he has that speed to get by. Keeps him to the outside. You got to have your goaltender make that save.
One goal game here. The Oilers come up with the puck. Darnell Nurse gets it out of the zone. And that's going to do it. Final score, 4-3. The Edmonton Oilers have won 3 in a row for just the 3rd time this season.
Well, you heard it right there. The Oilers come into Vegas and get their 3rd straight win against the club. Clem Costin does it again as he has goals in 3 straight games for the first time in his career. And Connor McDavid is now on a 7-game point streak thanks to his lone assist. He has 11 points over that span. And with this 3rd multi-goal game of the season against the Golden Knights, Leon Dreisaitl has 35 since the start of his incredible 2019-20 season. Now that ties him for the league lead in that span with back-to-back Rocket Richard Trophy winner Austin Matthews. Staying out west, we've got the Devils and the Kings.
And so now the Devils have won 3 in a row. They're 5-1-1 in their last 7. The Kings are red hot as well. They've won 3 straight and 10 of their last 13.
So now the Kings' first chance, man advantage.
On the right point, Kempe for the Hashes. Kempe to the yellow, they score! Tap in goal for Kevin Fiala. And it's 1-0 LA.
Devils down 1, looking to even things up.
It's Devils 0-1 in the power play, but got some quality looks. Hughes moving, shoots, rebound, score!
Nice save initially by Quick, but Tomas Tatar is right on the doorstep to roof it and bury the rebound and tie this hockey game up on the power play.
Devils have been 2-on-1. Halla with Boqvist. Halla shoots. He scores! Eric Halla's 3rd of the year puts the Devils ahead.
And there Halla along with Boqvist. There was no hesitation. He knew what he was going to do, and he rips the wrist shot. Looked like Quick got a little piece of it, but it seemed to go under the right arm.
And the Kings will go to the power play.
Now it's time for the Kings to take advantage of that.
Doughty again up top. Doughty pulls the trigger. Tap, score! Kopitar! Power play goal ties the game at 2.
He has a stick free to get the redirection.
Devils have to get that back and get things tilted their way again.
Finding the trailer, Ohotyuk looking for some space. Ohotyuk shoots, he scores! Nikita Ohotyuk has his 2nd career goal and the Devils lead.
Terrific answer, and Jonathan Quick's got to stop this. Devils will take it, though.
Sharangovich settles the puck down. He spins back. Graves, bouncing puck, score! It
deflected off Fiala and then kept on skipping in. Ryan Graves puts the Devils up two.
Well, Devils getting some puck luck here tonight, but the Devils take a 4-2 lead. Well, this is an important 20 here in the third period.
Here we go. And the Kings get a friendly bounce. Here's Fiala moving in, partial break, and he draws a hooking penalty. Fouled from behind. It's a penalty shot. Clear as day. Chance to get back within one here.
Crucial moment with the Devils up two. Blackwood stuffs him.
Oh, baby, what a save at a key time of this game in the third period.
Jonathan Quick going to the bench here for the extra attacker, Jim.
Reeves knocks it forward. Sharon Govich for Brett. He makes no mistake this time. 5-2.
I think that one ices it.
The Devils win their fourth straight and have scored at least four goals in each of their wins. Now, Jack Hughes had two helpers on the night and has five multi-point games in his last six contests. And the netminder also gets his first win in the new year. When we come back, the Flames came out hot in Dallas, putting up a six spot through two. But could they weather the Stars' furious comeback in the third? Highlights from the showcase are next. Welcome back to On the Fly. Well, Saturday got started with a bang on the NHL Network showcase between the Flames and the Stars. Now let's get the highlights from Steven Nelson and Kevin Weeks.
The Dallas Stars in their blackout uniforms. Calgary Flames turnover in front. Score! How's that for a start for Calgary?
And this was nice indirect play off the boards by Mangiapane, who puts this puck in an area. Stars need to be harder on that puck on the boards. Not only do they not manage it, but they also don't win the board battles either. Great second support, a bit of a fortuitous bounce. And it's Mangiapane off the play right here by Backlund. And watch Mangiapane pop out from the goal line and goes all the way to his left on the backhand, slides it under Wedgwood.
Youngest ever shoot up for the Golden Eagles.
Yep, last few seconds. Rebound, score! Trevor Lewis was right there.
Credit to Trevor Lewis here, Nelly. He stayed in motion, started with the hit, finished with the goal.
Good work by him. Shorthanded chance, a shorthanded goal! Jamie Benn scored the goal. Ty Dellandrea did the work.
Zadorov is a big man. Yes, he overskates this one, but look at the dogged pursuit by Ty Dellandrea.
Down low, Lindholm. Toffoli has some space, left circle, shoots, scores!
Gets the D to open up, five hole on three players. And this actually goes in off of Lindholm, off the leg.
Huberdeau comes in, a pass to Kadri, who scores!
Huberdeau pulls the defenders back, gets this to Nazem Kadri, and there's no chance here for Wedgwood.
You can see his glove pop.
Yes.
Right?
Which means the puck is in the glove at that point.
After video review, the call on the ice stands. Yeah. Good goal.
Just beyond the reach of Kadri, who has to chase after it. Anderson will let it go and score!
Foot race, go up high to Rasmus Anderson.
Flames keep the zone far side. Tanev will shoot, and Tanev will score. It's a sixth spot for Calgary. Centering pass shot, score! There's Sagan from Robertson. Lindell, far side, tipped in front. Net comes off the mooring. That's a good goal.
So here's the diagonal seam. Quick touch, one touch, strong bottom hand, which is the right hand of Joe Pavelski. That's the key. Strong bottom hand on the backhand to get that toward the net.
Haskinen, he will fire. Score!
Get the zone entry. Down low beneath the goal line, and they go from low to high.
Anderson's pass. Picked up by the other number four, Haskinen. Miller lets it go. Score!
No dusting it off, but it's a play by Johnson to let that go through his legs. Watch Miller skate into this one. He got a lot of ice contact before he shot it, too.
Tanev, last 3 seconds. The Flames will survive.
Textbook start of the game for the Calgary Flames. They battled exceptionally hard.
Great call there by Steven Nelson and Kevin Weeks as the Stars give a valiant effort at the attempted five-goal comeback, but fall just short to the Flames. Now Nazem Kadri extends his point streak to 5 games with a goal and an assist. Meanwhile, Jason Robertson became the fourth player this season to reach the 60-point mark with a pair of helpers. The showcase returns next Saturday with Trevor Zegras and the Ducks in Buffalo to take on Tage Thompson and the Sabres. Early puck drop for this one at 12:30 Eastern. Now, speaking of the Sabres, they were in Nashville taking on the Preds.
Taken away by Tage Thompson. He's got Skinner wide open. Finds him for a breakaway. Skinner between the circles. Deeks scores! What a pass! What a find! And what a finish for the 1-0 lead.
Here it is coming out of the zone. Here's Tage Thompson. Picks it up. He finds Jeff Skinner all by himself. At the just side of the far blue line. What a move. Goes to the backhand. Gets Harold down. Quick, look at his feet.
Yossi rips it.
Just ran over and just puts it on a tee for Yossi. And just overpowers Lucan.
Here's Cousins. Finds a way in. Scores! Dylan Cousins! With a snapper that gets by Saros. And it's a 2-1 Sabres lead early in the second period.
Mittelstadt up top to Power. One-timer from Olsen. Scores!
There's the Rocket Man firing one past Saros there, and the Sabres power play does indeed get the job done. It's 3-1 Buffalo.
Glass has it behind the net. Got a man. Lozon
scores. That goes back to within one. Jeremy Lozon on the pass from behind the net from Glass. It's 3-2.
Catch him? Just
awesome.
Did he catch him?
Scores! Ryan Johansson has tied the game.
They probably went 10 feet in the air on that goal. It came out of nowhere. What a response and follow-up by the Predators.
Cousins was there. Now in front, score! Short-handed goal! Kyle Oposo goes to the net! And Laverskin finds him, and the Sabres with a short-handed goal take a 4-3 lead. Now it's stolen by Quinn. Walks it, scores! The mighty Quinn puts the Sabres up by two. They lead it 5-3 late in the third period. Lukanen with career win 13, his 10th of the season. And as we say goodnight from Nashville, we say go Bills tomorrow against the Dolphins.
And with that, Buffalo snaps their three-game losing streak with a huge 5-3 win over the Preds. Now a whopping 12 players get at least a point in the victory, including rookie Jack Quinn, who earns his fourth multi-point game this season. Kyle Kposo also gets the fourth shorthanded goal of his career. Next up, we're headed out to Denver. Could the Avs snap out of their funk and get back in the win call?
Colorado Avalanche, who have struggled mightily with injuries all season. They've done well until recently, where the wheels have absolutely fallen off.
Rammed ahead. Here's Mikko. Wants to send it across the ice. McKinnon gives it back. Score! Mikko Rantanen. The Moose just got loose for his 28th goal of the season.
But then right there, a quick pass and a quick shot. They're not going to overcomplicate things. They're a little bit sketchy defensively, and so far we've seen that.
New hook shoot! And score!
Steps up and buries it.
Oh, that's an awesome goal. And here comes Lekkinen. He's got a baby break, trying to shield the man off. Backhanded, save, rebound. It's in the back of the net.
Here's the key to the play. He puts the brakes on and does not run over Forsberg. Puts on the brakes, no interference, and Forsberg's own power takes him into the back.
Look in the middle of the ice, drops it off. Newhook got a stick on, no penalty call. Shot,
stays with it, jumps right onto his stick.
Here's Kane. Snaps it ahead for McKinnon. Steves it down the slot. Lekkinen scores! Artturi Lekkinen was left all alone. And yes, he went backhand right through the five hole for his second goal.
Look at this beauty pass. And that's what happens when you start scoring goals. Then it turns into highlight time.
Swings it for England. Doesn't tee it up, but Hunt will! Some nice ones, but he's turnover. Oh, Cogliano stick broken up. Score! Dominant performance tonight on the home ice by the Colorado Avalanche, and it is a shutout for Pavel Francouz.
Great call there by the Marks, and what a win for the Avs as they blank the Senators 7-0. Mikko Rantanen finds the back of the net twice, upping his total to 29 on the season, and is one shy of his third consecutive 30-goal campaign. And how about Pavel Francouz, who earns his first shutout this season as he stops all 29 shots faced. When we return, a franchise icon was honored on Long Island. It was Mike Bossy night at UBS Arena. Highlights from the Habs and Isles after the break. Well, Seattle has been unbeaten in their last 8 games as they set a franchise record 8-game win streak. They're averaging over 5 goals per contest and just 2 goals against per game. Now, they also have been really solid on the power play, scoring in 5 of their last 20 opportunities. Now, let's get you back to the highlights. It was a special night on Long Island, Habs and Islanders.
It is a very special night as the Islanders are honoring Mike Bossy as part of their 50th anniversary celebration and their Legends Night.
Mike Bossy's family in attendance acknowledged here by the crowd.
Off the ball out of the net. He'll play the puck around the boards. Got away from Cal Clutterbuck.
There's a shot. They score! Dobson shot tipped in by Casey Cizikas. And the Islanders get one early tonight.
It's the relentless forecheck of the Islanders. They're on their toes. They've got their mind. Winning.
Mayfield shot, rebound, score! Anthony Beauvillier! And it's 2 early.
The Islanders are really taking it to the Montreal Canadiens. It is a big-time effort, energy, and commitment.
Joel Edmondson, left side for Cole Caulfield. Their leading goal scorer, the setup, and Sorokin denies Kirby Dach.
Are you kidding me? Holy smokes, that was going up in the toy department. And he said, that's like picking apples off a tree.
Rod Nelson will line up against Jake Evans. They've got to back Evans up again. Another little battle with Nelson and Evans. And Nelson falls on Jake Evans. And he looks hurt at center ice here. He fell on his leg awkwardly. And Evans now down on all fours. Now it's carried up by Aho. Out the middle for Barzell. Over the line to Zach Parise. Cross height. Pass coming in. Great shot on it by Bailey. Kicked up by Montembeau.
That's a real nice save by Montembeau.
Jonathan Drouin hands it off. Suzuki going to net. He scores! Nick Suzuki snaps his 11-game goal as Stroud. His first since December 17th. And the Canadians are finally on the board.
2 seconds and one more poke check from Cal Clutterbuck will end it. The Islanders snap a 4-game skid with a 2-1 win over Montreal.
A hard-fought win.
They moved ahead of the Pittsburgh Penguins and back into that final wild card spot.
Yeah, how about that? The Islanders snapped their 4-game losing skid with a 2-1 victory over the Canadiens. Now, 6 different players find the score sheet in this one, including both Casey Cizikas and Anthony Beauvillier, who each get a goal in the first period to help lead the Isles to victory. Now, let's head down to Sunrise for the Panthers and the Canucks.
That was broken up. Here's Jack Stadnicka. Scores! Bobrovsky. It's just a knuckler, and it's into the net to make it 1-0 Vancouver.
Gustav looking for a lane. He has one. Save, rebound, score! Ryan Lomberg with the tip-in. The Panthers have tied it at 1.
There's the shot from Forsling. He made sure he gets that puck right at the net. Ryan Lomberg gets the goal.
Kuzmenko there for Vancouver as well. Now Pettersson gets it back to the blue line. Tyler Myers, long shot, scores! Bobrovsky never saw it. That one had a little more zip to it, but he never moved. And another long-distance goal makes it 2-1 Vancouver.
Cousins keeps it alive. Maher from the point, sends it in front, score! It's Eric Staal deflected in. They've tied the game, and Staal continues to move up the all-time goals list. Peel back, got Montour in the slot, Ekblad, one-timer, there it is! Aaron Ekblad hammers it home with a power play, and the Panthers have their first lead of the night.
They want Ekblad to be open for that one-timer, and slid right over to him, and he drills it short side.
Here's the one-timer by Ekblad again. Martin stops that one. Barkov in front, stuffs it in! Another power play goal, and Sasha Barkov makes it 4-2.
Hughes, Pedersen, long shot, he scores! Horvat was in front, but I think it went clean through. And the Canucks count one on the power play to make it a one-goal game.
Here's Miller centering the chance, Bobrovsky with a save with 10 seconds left. Panthers clear the zone. Sergei Bobrovsky robbed the Vancouver Canucks, and he should be fired up.
Goodrow. Johnny Goodrow cycling.
Laine scores! What a pass and what a goal! And for Patrick Laine, that's his first goal in 10 games, and what a feed by Goodrow.
I can see the relief right away as he pointed back to Johnny Goodrow.
Across the line now, Kent Johnson with a shot, rebound! Husso, the puck is still loose! And the Jackets are up 2-0 with the loose puck, the scramble around the net, and have back-to-back goals and a 2-0 lead. Roslovic cruising down the right side. Goodrow shot by Roslovic off the back wall, scored! Patrick Laine, that puck came right back to him, and it's 3-0 Columbus.
A nice little 3 minutes here for the Blue Jackets.
Pass knock right back onto his stick. Quick shot there, scores! Goal scores. What did I say in that first period? When they're hot, they're hot.
Patrick with a hat trick. Beautiful pass across the ice.
Back for Mata. Kick save. Oh!
That's about as big a break as you could get.
His favorite team also sent him a helmet that he's been wearing. Here's the shot, the score! Within a couple now! Walbert buries another one! Aronek slot, Beckett scores! Raymond!
Nice play by Sherratt, doesn't score many backhands.
Kaprizov on front, Eriksson, saved by Ingram. Rebound is loose. Still no whistle. It goes to the corner. Eriksson, Ekdomoldi, Addison. Kaprizov centers. Zuccarello scores!
This play is about progression. We've seen Kaprizov and Zuccarello behind the net, tic-tac-toe. This time they throw it out. It's not the two of them. They find Eriksson, Ek stick. That one doesn't go, but they stick with it.
Minnesota snaps a 0-for-9 on the power play. Hartman in. Hartman centered. They score! Freddie Goodrow! A pair of power play goals, and Minnesota leads it 2-0.
Things can change fast while taking advantage of the 5-on-3, and then Freddie Goodrow finds Hartman on the backside with nice patience. He doesn't throw that one in the pads of Ingram. He pulls him out of the net even further, brings him to the corner. Then he finds Goodrow posted up on that backside, ready to play, stick on the ice.
That's the green light I'm talking about.
Chance of falling in a backhander, and a rebound, and they score.
And Lawson Crouse has made it a one-goal game. And the Wild hang on for a 2-1 win at home. Back-to-back victories for Minnesota.
Well, the Wild get the 2-1 victory over the Coyotes as Sam Steele collects an assist, which extends his point streak to 3 straight games. And Frederick Goudreau gets a goal on the night, giving him a tally in back-to-back contests. And how about this? 12 of Matt Zuccarello's 20 goals this season have come at home. Must be the cooking. And now for the best from Saturday, we're going top shelf.
Makes it 4-0. Here's Kane. Snaps it ahead for McKinnon. Steves it down the slot. Lekkonen scores! Artturi Lekkonen was left on a line. Roberts. Cross ice pass, Giordano. Oh, what a recovery by Omark. The save of the game. Linus Omark down and out. And he lunges to block the puck.
Reams like fire, deflected away. Follow, chance stop. Rebound, score! Alex Ovechkin hits 30.
Ovi on the backhand rips it up and over Carter Hart. And again, in the history books for number 8, Alex Ovechkin.
Welcome back to On the Fly. Highlights from the U18 Women's World Championship semifinals between the U.S. and Sweden.
Just one goal difference in that 3-2 victory for the United States. Scandal actually tied it up in the third period. Dieter Alamo gets the opening goal. Lucia Dieter Alamo, her second goal of the tournament, makes it 1-0 United States. Beats her player down low in nice positioning right there. Dieter Alamo gets out of the paint. Backhand to protect the puck. It's a beautiful play. A large opportunity now for Team Sweden. Two-player advantage. Edvis weighing her options. Ronio to Jungekar. Jungekar steps, she scores. Mira Jungekar has tied it up. A 5-on-3, and Sweden capitalizes. Mira Jungekar gets her third of the tournament.
Well, she's been all around the net. I mean, she has been so active on the blue line. You know that she's waiting for that shot. She's delaying to try and open up the lane, and she buries it.
Returns to the power play. Chance out in front for St. Martin to get tied up. With control, Lindenberg shot, she scores. Sweden takes the lead, a power play goal. It's 2-1 for the hometown team.
Wow, specialty teams have been the difference so far in this game, and head up, recognize it doesn't have to be hard. Let's keep it low, and that's exactly where it was kept.
Dunn catches it down, she'll play it. Dunn, Wayne, her shot, save made, rebound.
Point. It did look like it hit the crossbar. Cassie Hall, who's had a number of shots on net, just up over the pad, just creating a screen, and that is off the crossbar, and that does not look like that is going to be a good goal.
It is no goal. 8 seconds to go to Jordan. Out in front, 3 seconds remaining. The buzzer goes. Sweden will play for gold on home soil. Sweden has defeated the United States 2-1 in the semifinal action.
And with their loss to Sweden, Team USA will face off against Finland for the bronze medal Sunday at 10 a.m. Eastern. And you can see Canada and Sweden in the gold medal game at 2 o'clock. Now you can watch both contests right here on NHL Network. It's time now for your three stars of the night. Our third star is Pavel Francouz, who had recorded his first shutout of the season after stopping all 29 shots against the Senators. Our second star is Patrick Laine, who recorded his 10th career hattie Saturday against the Red Wings. Now that's the fourth most since his debut in the 2016-17 season. And our first star belongs to Jared McCann as he picked up his first NHL hat trick against the Blackhawks. Now McCann finished the 7-game road trip with 6 goals total. Well, that does it for this edition of OTF. For our great crew here at NHL Network, I'm LG Red. See you next time.
It is a very special night as the Islanders are honoring Mike Bossy.
The Moose just got loose.
Absolutely lasers that.
25 seconds in.
Bingo.
Scores! Hattie's got a hattie!
10th career hat trick for Patrick Laine.
Are you kidding me? That's like picking apples off a tree.
Alex Ovechkin, 17th time. He's hit 30 goals. Hat trick, Jared McCann.
Absolute BB to the back of the net.
Great hand eye as he one times that one from the sky.
He scores! What a game!